everyone, it's Vicky, and in front of me I have another unboxing. I feel like I am just so incredibly lucky to be receiving all these wonderful packages in the mail. This, if you notice the logo down here at the bottom, is from Lisle, and I have done a review before on this beautiful notebook, and this was my first gift from Lisle, and I absolutely think it's stunning, and it is housing my 2019 Hobonichi currently. So let's take a peek inside of here. Comes beautifully bubble wrapped and packaged, so no need for concerns in regards to how it's going to arrive. Now, once we kind of get the bubble wrap off, you'll notice there's the Lisle washi tape. I mentioned before, this is kind of a newer company on the scene. They're from Taiwan, do beautiful work. And this is a surprise. This is like a Christmas gift to me, so I don't know what's inside. So drum roll. Oh my gosh. Oh my goodness. Wow, okay, the aroma that just came out of that was amazing. This is so beautiful. So let me pull this little card out here. How cute, it's a little Merry Christmas card. So it just says, thanks for the big help to my shop last time. Wish the early Xmas gift will arrive before Christmas. Best wishes from Diamond. That is too cute. How pretty is that? This is an A5 size. I've got to say, I love this little details that came with this. So this is a cute little button. It's a button closure. So there's elastic here, and the elastic closes beautifully on here. This may have to be my Hobonichi holder as well, or journal keeper, because I love that idea. I love having the elastic here more so than the traveler's notebook style, especially when it comes to the notebooks that I really prefer to have in like a folio format. I really love that for that. Now, the other impressive design here is like the quilting pattern of the leathers. So this is all leather that is like in a quilted pattern. And I had mentioned to Diamond before, I had said, I think this is something that I would love to have in my collection, because I love how that quilting looks. It's just such a beautiful way of putting leather pieces, I think, together. A lot of times my journals are like such a creative place that I think that enhances the idea of creativity, as well as a cute little wooden kind of puzzle piece there. I just love that little touch. That is just such a cute little touch. So this is a functional pocket on the front here, as well as on the back. And then we have a beautiful natural tan, excuse me, a natural leather here. So this will tan beautifully. This is like a beautiful soft chocolate kind of brown color here. So the colors are beautifully put together. Even sewing this together, I would imagine, takes some sort of master skill to kind of put that together. Inside, let's take a quick peek in here. We have a beautiful pocket to kind of house the idea of having maybe a secretarial, folio style type of notebook maybe, and then utilizing the elastics to kind of house any extra pieces of paper you may have, or any extra ephemera. Here we have, oh my god, these are so cute. So this is it's from the Republic of Taiwan, and they're little sticker flakes. So the little sticker flakes that are inside of here are these adorable little like socks. It says travel time, little suitcases, cameras, planes, all kinds of adorable little ephemera bits are inside of there. And then of course an extra elastic, which is really nice to have in case your elastic wears thin, it snaps, or anything like that. You have extra elastic that is provided to you. That is a really, really nice touch to have. The notebook inside of here is blank, which is my preferred, my favorite. It's got really nice paper in here with perforations. I love having the perforations in there. So there's two little kind of card slots in here. I love the beautiful red in here. The way that the notebook is put together, it's burnished, but it doesn't have the exact same kind of burnishing that I've seen with like apple pig leather, where it's more like a brown for some reason. It looks like it's almost melted. This is beautifully melted, so there's nothing kind of fuzzy sticking out. It's really nicely finished. It's got really nice kind of rounded edges in here. I love the yellow stitching that goes in and kind of complements the colors. I love the palette that we're really working with here. The suede interior is really beautiful. I'm gonna pull the notebook out so you can really kind of get an idea of what this looks like. The red, the yellow, I love the kind of color scheme. Then we have another kind of secretarial pocket in the back here, as well as a beautiful little pen loop. The leather is nice and soft, kind of beautiful, like a cherry red kind of color. The leather, I'm trying to see if these are the same type of leather. This red leather seems to me more floppier and softer. This one feels like maybe it's a little firmer, but I could be completely wrong in that regard, but it's very, very thin nonetheless. So we're not getting something extremely thick, if you can see that. We're not getting something super duper thick. I know some companies, when they're making pockets and extra folios and things like that, it can look very thick. This leather is really very nice weight. It's very substantial. It is really kind of nice and floppy. So just to show you how kind of nice and floppy the leather is, it's done beautifully. Like the structure of this, the aroma is amazing. If I could just slap lotion like this on my body, I love it. There was someone who was teasing me, making fun of me, for enjoying the aroma that leather has, and they were saying it's just the chemicals on dead skin. So I think that's really funny. So yeah, this will beautiful. This will become like a golden kind of a color. This has a very. This will have a natural patina, so it's just like a veg tan leather to have on the spine there. So that's really beautiful. I do really love the color patterns on here. I love this beautiful red. It's more of like a burgundy-ish. This is a really beautiful pattern. I love the colors that are put together on this. I love this green. It's such a beautiful green, kind of like a moss green. You have like an evergreen in here. This is like a beautiful kind of almost dark brown green kind of color. So it all really nicely complement one another. I love the sizes. I love the idea of this kind of quilted leather, but I really gotta say, I love this button. This is such a unique and cute closure. I just love that. It's just so dang cute. It's just adorable. So let me see if I put in my Hobonichi. Let's take a look here. Let's see if it would work what I'm thinking. So I right now have it in a cover on cover. I might have to pop it out of that. But I was wondering if I did this. Pulling it out of here. Let's see here. If I were to kind of make a more folio style out of this. Okay. So kind of have it more of like this, and then utilize my, oops, I'm out of frame, of course, utilize my elastics a little bit more for extra ephemera bits or an extra maybe kind of notebook. So I could have an extra notebook in here as well as my Hobonichi, and then it can be kind of housed within is what I'm kind of thinking of using that more so for, because I like the folio idea more for these bound books than I do to have using the strings. What I find with the strings is, especially in like a heavier bound book, the spine here and at the bottom, the elastic tends to wear on that, and it causes kind of some cutting into the paper and kind of into the work of that. So I don't care for that very much, but this fits the Hobonichi really beautifully in here, as you can see, as a folio. So I can also pop this top portion in here and have it kind of more in that book format. I prefer to kind of have mine just like this, as then I can put my kind of extra bits and bobs in here and then utilize this for extra paper, extra ephemera. Putting in kind of like notebooks, I can show you, let's see. So like I have vellum that's folded in half with like extra bits and bobs. So if I were to thread my elastic like this on here, I have like a folder, kind of pseudo folder in here to kind of house extra goodies. And then if I wanted to utilize these elastics behind the Hobonichi, then what I could do is take the front cover, pop it into here, and then I would have the bits and bobs kind of in the back as opposed to in the front. But I like having the elastics utilized in that way. This is an absolutely amazing and beautiful gift. I couldn't be more thrilled with this. I just love it. I just can't decide if I'm gonna use this for my Hobonichi or the red one for my Hobonichi. I think maybe I'll just kind of flip-flop them together. The leather quality, the craftsmanship is absolutely impeccable. I highly recommend that you check out the brand. They're really beautiful. Diamond does a beautiful, beautiful job. Thank you so much for my Christmas present. I can't tell you how excited this makes me. I'm super close to having baby number 3, so this will be something really beautiful for me to even take to the hospital with me to kind of document and cherish a lot of the memories that I will have there, as well as with my newest family member coming very, very soon. Thank you all so much for watching, for your support, and I'll see you again very soon. Take care. Bye-bye.